Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum, dear students. Our current session focuses on the extended concept of diglossia. I hope and expect by the end of this session, you would have an understanding of the extension that was later on made in the concept of diglossia. Well, my dear students, I hope and expect you already know what is diglossia. That is the use of a high variety of language and the low variety of a language, that is the same language, in the same society for two different sets of uses. Well, initially the idea or the concept of diglossia, I hope you know, was presented by, you know, Ferguson in 1959. However, to Ferguson, the idea was a very restricted idea, and he clearly made the distinction and pointed out that in the diglossic situation, the language itself is one and the same. However, within that language, there are the two varieties that exist. High variety has certain functions allocated to it, and the low variety has another set of functions that is allocated to this particular variety. The distinction was on the basis of that the language that these two varieties share is the same. However, later on, you know, the concept was further extended, and in fact, it was Joshua Fishman who extended the concept in 1967. And he extended the concept in two ways. Firstly, he extended it in terms of this, you know, idea of the same language. He proposed this differentiation from the original concept that was given by Ferguson in 1959 in two respects. Firstly, a diglossic speech community is not characterized by the use of two varieties only. So, you know, according to Fishman, it's not restricted to two varieties, a high variety and a low variety. There can be more than two varieties. In fact, there are many varieties according to Fishman. So, you know, all these varieties are used in the community for different purposes. Now, there can be different situations of the coexistence of these varieties. There is a possibility that there is one high variety and one or more than one low varieties. Now, these low varieties would vary from each other in certain ways, for example, in terms of vocabulary choices or in terms of pronunciation, etc. But they would coexist within the society in different groups or in different kind of, you know, social communities, and they would be used simultaneously. The high variety, however, would be used for certain kind of formal functions that are allocated to its use. For example, formal academic writing, business writing, for example, literature, or any other kinds of formal writing. Also for other formal purposes of speech, such as for government, such as for, you know, sermons, or for, you know, any official uses. According to the second, you know, characteristic where Fishman's concept, you know, is an extension of the idea that was given by Ferguson, this is that diglossia refers to all kinds of language varieties which show functional distribution. So, you know, the concept of high variety and low variety, according to this definition, does not exist according to this extension. If there are, you know, if there is a set of functions as set A, and there is a set of functions as set B, and set of functions as set C, and three different varieties X, Y, and Z are used to perform these sets of functions, this would be called a diglossic situation according to this extended version of diglossia. And it is not compulsory, or it is not necessary, that one variety is higher and others are not. So, my dear students, diglossia as a consequence describes a number of sociolinguistic situations in this context, from stylistic differences within one language or the use of separate dialects to separate languages. So, you know, if we accept Fishman's this definition, this then would extend to a lot of societies, to a lot of varied situations where, you know, multiple varieties of dialects or sociolects coexist, or multiple languages in multilingual situations coexist, and where, you know, certain varieties in pronunciation or certain varieties in vocabulary or structure would differentiate one from the other.